I did everything that I was asked. I sacrificed myself, my family. I led us into the new world. I thought that it would be glorious. I was wrong. I have waited so long for someone to come. I've begun to despair. I have seen your face before. God showed it to me in a dream. I knew you would be the one to come and make things right. Set them exactly the way they're supposed to be. I knew that you would bring salvation. You've come seeking help. I can't give you any, only God can. But he has a plan for you. Come. Walk with me. After God's cleansing fire, I saw the journey he had laid out before us, and I knew what was required when we set foot on our new Eden. When humanity emerged, I gathered my flock and set them on a new path, a rejection of my despair. And in that despair, I found our salvation. It's fruit, a gift from God, which gave my family the strength to endure through the famine and the pestilence. New Eden bride, we created a paradise on earth, but it did not last. This plague of locusts saw to that. Highwaymen embody everything God has instructed us to forsake. Their souls are rotten, diseased. But you are different. I believe your soul is worthy. This is the help that you've been seeking. God's gift to us. That which sustained my family through the darkest time. miracle. The first time that I partook of this gift, I was confronted by a ravenous beast. It was my soul. And in that moment, I knew that in order to be worthy of God's gift, I had to slay that beast. I had to cleanse my soul. Because if I did not, I knew that that beast would consume me. This is God's test. If your soul is pure, you are the shepherd sent by God, and I can return from my exile. Our miracle allowed us to survive, but its gifts are not unconditional. It nourishes what is in a person's soul. But if that soul is corrupt, the miracle extracts a terrible price. coursing through you. That is why I am here. There are those who must not be allowed to partake of this miracle. Even if I love them. Even if they are of my family. Sin is a beast we cannot be.
Shepherd of my people. Come with me to New Eden. Our future depends on adherence to my strictures. We can no longer hope for Joseph to save us. He is not coming back. We must put him out of our minds and... Father.
Ethan. Father?
The father.
Where have you been? Our land is under siege, our people threatened. You disappeared. You left us when we needed you most. Why?
To hear God's plan, my son. To hear God's plan. My children. I know that you have suffered. And I know that you are afraid. I've been gone from you for a very long time. But you were not abandoned. God spoke to me, and he has shown me a path out of this darkness. We will no longer hide behind these walls. We will no longer simply hope that this plague of locusts leaves us in peace. The time to fight is now. God has sent us his sword. Here! God has tested their soul, and it is just, and it is pure. And I stand here before you to bear witness that this outsider is our shepherd.
Father!
And together, we will battle against the hordes outside our gates. And together we will march towards the future that God has promised us.
No! You abandoned me. You abandoned us. Without a word, without instructions, leaving me to lead as best I could. And now, you return. As if descended from the clouds and presumed to lead?
Yes.
I am the leader here.
Joseph is our leader.
New Eden follows me!
We stand behind the Father.
Son, I know you've carried a heavy burden in my absence. I understand that. This is God's will. And sometimes we must sacrifice that which we want in order to honor God's command.
What have you ever sacrificed?
Someday you will see the light. I promise.
Come, let us all go together.
We have much work to do.
Go in peace. I wish to speak with you. Already my chosen fight the highwaymen throughout the long nights. Now I will ask them to find the strength to fight in the day as well. Your friend should make good use of the distraction and act quickly. My family cannot fight forever. As for you, remember God's gift. What you have experienced so far is just a taste of God's power. Do not waste it. I will also give leave for my judge to follow you. They speak only one language, that of violence. In this, they will serve you well. Before you can be our shepherd, you must be our sword. Go and make the land safe for all who wish to live in peace. You have come here to help your people. Admirable.
I wish we could fight the highwaymen in a day.
I admire your fortitude.
We are all sinners. Ethan's sin is pride. There is something deep inside of him that no word of mine can touch. I worry that now, as an outsider appears to take his place, that beast will feed on resentment and grow stronger. I should remind him of his mother. She put aside her pride, and it saved his life. He would have been too young to understand. He should understand now.
I wonder what gifts lie in store for you.
Let's remember the Father's teachings.
Condolences for your home.
Thank you. Paul's hand sure looks a mess, but it's our mess now.
Don't tell that one, Paul.
You've done nice work up north, Cap. Come on back. We'll talk over what we can do here in Prosperity.
Us together at Prosperity. Thank you.
You're in a different headspace than
back in one piece. Glad you're back, Captain. You got Joseph Seed on our side. I hope it didn't come at too high a price. There's something different about you. You've changed. But now the New Eden's attacking the Highwaymen. The twins are fighting a war on two fronts. We need to take advantage of this. You've done good work in Prosperity, but it's still not enough. We need more specialists, and we need to invest some ethanol in our facilities. That's the key to getting Prosperity back up and running again. Once this place is at its peak, we'll be in a good spot to really take the fight to Mickey and Lou. While you're out doing that, I'm gonna do some recon, see if we can't get a foothold deeper in their territory. I'll meet you back here once you're done.
If we can get the Peggy's to dial up their attacks, it'll give us some room to rebuild.
I appreciate you working to get New Eden to help us out.
Who knew the end of civilization would look so beautiful?
Yeah, I know.
Thank God these walls have been intact.
You went full beast mode during the siege. It was awesome.
Open the gates!
Thank you.
door.
You just saved my life.
Hey, asshole. We've had some biting crap out on us. Are you fucking him up on purpose? Because if you won't,
holy
not
shit.
Only will we kill you,
that was unbelievable.
Your family too. Come on up.
Whoa! Thank you. Thank you so damn much. You don't understand. I've been trapped here for months. See, the highwaymen dragged me out to this camp, and they had me working on stuff for the twins. I need to get back home. I got a getaway ride all ready to go. Come on, let's get moving before more of those sons of bitches show up. Name's Nick, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, that's fucked.
Hey, follow me. I got an idea. My plane pulled up in a boat shed just down that hill over there. I was taking her for a test drive when these assholes showed up and caught me with my pants down. Not literally, of course. They dragged the two of us all the way out here and had me working on the thing so they could give it to the twins. Not only that, they had me working on a replica so they could both have one. Anyway, I knew that if I was ever gonna get out of here, she'd be my ticket. So I just kept fixing her up. Now, she ain't finished, but she works. And we're gonna use her to bust on out of here, friend. There she is. Like I said, not
finished. Mostly the flying part. But ain't she a beauty? Now go on, grab the wheel. I'll keep a lookout for any trouble.
Hey, let's get the hell on out of here! Straight ahead! Gunfire! Stay alert!
Hold on to your lunch! Help! left up ahead! Yeah.
giant pig got away. We were gonna cook that up for the party after the derby. I don't like looking weak in front of the visiting highwaymen chapters.